In this video, we will cover how to create a virtual joystick for use on mobile and move a character with that joystick. Please check the video related to the movement of the character by clicking the link in the upper right corner of the screen. First, let's prepare the joystick UI. Let's create a background image first. Then I'm going to add a stick image as a child of the background image. I will create a script file named manager joystick. And then apply that script to the joystick's background image. First, let's add the Unity Engine UI directive to enable UI use. Now, let's add two variables to get the joystick background and stick image. And in the start method, I'm going to write codes to get image components for variables. Before making the function of the joystick, let's start with the concept by watching the video. First of all, we need to click or touch the image to use the joystick. And while dragging, we need to measure the values of the X and Y coordinates. Finally, we are going to move the character with the coordinates obtained in this way. To touch or point an image, we need the functions of event systems. I'm going to add an event systems directive to use those features. Event systems provides a variety of classes related to manipulation, such as touch or pointing. First, let's add an IDragHandler class that contains drag-related functions. When adding some Unity-provided classes, be sure to add a reservation method to avoid errors. The IDragHandler reference class should add a method named onDrag. As we saw earlier, the touch information of the image is required, so we need to add the exclusive parameter pointEventData. Since dragging uses only the X and Y coordinates of the screen, I will add a vector2 variable to get the coordinates when dragging. And I'm going to add a conditional statement that determines whether the image is dragged. To do this, we need to use the rect transform utility and use the subcommand screen point to local point in rectangle. As you can see from the guide, four elements are required to complete this condition. Let's create elements one by one. The first one is the rect transform of the joystick background image. The second is the location of the pointer event data. The third is the camera where the event occurs. Finally, the drag coordinates obtained from the event are stored in a variable. I'm going to add debug code and see if the function works correctly. If I drag over the image, you can see that it works. However, we can see that the value gets very large as I move away from the center when dragging. If I manipulate the character as it is, there will be a problem that the character's movement speed becomes very fast. I solved this problem by dividing the position of the drag by the size of the image. As I drag, we can see things closer to one as you move away from the center of the image. Even if I drag outside the image, the number doesn't increase dramatically. Since we succeeded in obtaining the transformed value of the coordinates by dragging on the image, we will now move the stick image. To move the UI image, use the anchor position command of rect transform. Since only X and Y are used for the coordinates of the image, you can use the vector 2 variable. When I ran the game, we noticed that the stick moves. But you can see that the stick movement is insignificant due to the reason that the output value of the drag was reduced earlier. To fix this, simply multiply the size of the background image again. We can see that the stick movement has been modified for easy recognition. However, as I continue to drag, the stick moves out of the background image. I'm going to divide each X and Y value by 4 to limit the position of the stick image. I have limited the position of the stick image, but it looks like it's far from the original center point. To solve this problem, it seems like normalizing all values is good. It has been confirmed that the stick does not cross the background. To change the stick's movement limit, simply change the division value we just applied. This time, when we finish touching the stick image, we need to create a function that returns the stick image to the origin. To make this function, the event system needs to figure out the start and end of the user's touch. I'm going to add IPointerDownHandler and IPointerUpHandler reference classes to use that functionality. These reference classes must also add a reservation method. Let's add on pointer down reservation method that determines the start of the touch. And likewise, we need to add the pointer event data parameter. I'm going to make the onDrag method run so that when a touch starts, it immediately switches to the drag function. Next, I'm going to create a reservation method on pointerUp to fire an event when the touch is over. We need to initialize the vector2 variable so that the character doesn't move when the touch is over. And the stick image should also go back to its original position. At the start of the touch, dragging, and the end of the touch, we see that our intended functions are working fine. Now that the joystick is all functional, it's time to move the character with the joystick. Let's create two public float variables that can be referenced in scripts that manipulate the character. One public variable is for the x-axis and the other is for the y-axis. When the x-axis input occurs, it will return the value of x. And at the same time make keyboard input possible. Copy these codes and paste them into the input vertical variable, change x to y, and change get axis horizontal to vertical, and you're done. Let's open the character control script we created earlier and put the code to get the component of the manager joystick. You can learn this script through the link at the top right of the video. And after commenting out a code related to the input for movement, let's make each input variable refer to the manager joystick's float variable. Now let's run the game. When I operate the joystick, we can see that the character moves. It is also possible to move the character through the operation of the keyboard. That's all for today's video. Thank you, see you next time.